Welcome to another episode. Today we're going to share with you 5 things you need to know before visiting Niagara Falls. Roll the intro. No, I won't go back tonight with the habits of the restless me. I'm leaving all the... So Niagara Falls has been a beautiful tourist destination for a very long time. And if you are going to visit there or you're planning to visit Niagara Falls, the thing I'm gonna share with you in this video are going to help you a lot to plan your stay there. So without further ado, let's get started. The number one question people often ask themselves before, you know, planning to go to Niagara Falls is, how long should I spend there? And in my experience, you can explore the entire fall in one day. But if you want to relax and do other activities, 2 days is more than enough to enjoy the fall. We went there, we spent about 3 days there, and we had more than enough time to enjoy every single thing we wanted to see, to eat, the fall. It was absolutely incredible. So if you're planning to go to visit Niagara Falls, 2 days is literally more than enough for you to enjoy everything. So if you have a hard time choosing either the Canadian side or the American side to stay at, I will tell you right now, stay in the Canadian side because the view is so much better. There are way more activities to do in the Canadian side. You can go to arcades, you can go to a lot of restaurants, you have the falls, so many tours to see the fall in the Canadian side. And on the USA side, it's more like a park where people just come here for the day and then go back home. And they have some hotels, but I would say there are way more activities to do on the Canadian side. So if you want to choose a side, you have it right there, the Canadian side. Number three, the best way actually to see the fall is surprisingly for free. Although they have a lot of tours to help you to see the fall in different angles, but if you simply walk to the welcome center, either on the Canadian side or the USA side, the view is still absolutely beautiful. And it's actually, for me, I think it's the best way to see the fall is to just walk to the welcome center. It's beautiful, you are very close to the fall. So if you are on a budget, you don't want to spend money, that's a great way for you to enjoy the fall and see it. A lot of people also often ask, well, what do I do after I see the fall? You will be surprised to know that on the Canadian side, there are so many activities to do, like I said earlier. So many things to do. You have countless of beautiful restaurants with tasty food. You have arcades, you have bars, you have a lot of buffets who are so nice. We went to a buffet where you go to the top floor and then you get to see the fall at night with the light. It was so beautiful. So there are a lot of things to do besides seeing the fall. There are so many things to do, so you would not get bored. If you are adventurous and you want to actually get closer to the fall, one of the tours I recommend is the Maid of the Mist in the New York side, which is so fun. They take you, you have to go to a stairs and then you go behind the fall, you actually get wet, you can play with the water, and if you are lucky, you can actually see the rainbow, which we saw. It makes it made the whole experience so much more magical. So it's also one of the cheapest tour you can do there. If you are adventurous, you want to get wet, you want to get closer to the fall, definitely take that tour. It's so fun. You can spend some time there, you can play there. It's a great time. Another thing that I think it's important for you to know before you visit the fall is, even if you choose to stay, for example, in the New York side, if you do want to go visit the Canadian side, it's pretty easy. You just walk to a bridge and then you give $1, I think, when you're going to the Canadian side, and then you can just go there. So it's a very short walk, and when you are walking to go to either side, you get to see the view at the same time. You only give $1. Just make sure to bring your passport. So those are our 5 things you must know before going to visit Niagara Falls. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a comment, subscribe, and like, and also click on the video right there to see our last video from last week. And thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next episode.